And in some news breaking this minute, an F.I.R. has been registered against Karnataka BJP chief B.S. Yeddyurappa by a JDS MLA's son. And this after JDS worker Sharanagouda Kandkur, son of JDS MLA, submitted a complaint over an audio tape where Yeddyurappa is heard allegedly trying to poach JDS MLA with the offer of money and a ministerial berth. But the Yeddyurappa, on the other hand, has claimed that audio is completely doctored. My colleague Deepak Bukwarna now joining me live with further updates on this. Deepak, there's trouble there mounting for Karnataka BJP chief. Under what sections has a case been registered against B.S. Yeddyurappa?
Well, now what they're trying to do here is, rope in the clauses of Prevention of Corruption Act against B.S. Yeddyurappa, and that's the bigger cause of concern. Now, at this point in time, the Speaker had suggested to the Chief Minister of Karnataka that an SIT should be formed. But before that, we've seen a complaint that's come by from the person who allegedly, recorded this entire audio. That is the son of the MLA who B.S. Yeddyurappa allegedly tried to poach, Sharanagouda. Now, while the FIR was registered in Raichur, the Raichur police are the ones who've gone ahead and, taken up this FIR. Now we'll have to wait and watch whether he will be called in for questioning, what sort of action will be taken. And also, top sources in the police department tell us that this FIR could soon be transferred to the SIT that will be formed by the chief minister, because the speaker has ordered for a probe into this because he feels that even his name has been tarnished and it needs to be cleared out.
Also, Deepak, as you're pointing out that Prevention of Corruption Act, those sections have been invoked, but even Sharanagouda, the man in question who has filed this FIR, has also alleged threat and intimidation by B.S. Yeddyurappa when he turned down this offer.
Well, now there are two sides to this. While the allegation has come by initially that, B.S. Yeddyurappa tried to offer money, lure him with offers. Now, the question really arises as to why did this MLA son even approach B.S. Yeddyurappa or go to his residence because this conversation is not definitely happening between B.S. Yeddyurappa and Sharanagouda alone. There are a couple of other people there as well. So if he's gone to a particular place to have this discussion, what was the necessity in the first place? Did he go on the behest of somebody? Is that...